Hey everyone, Mark here. Today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different, and I'm going to be covering some very basic aerobatic maneuvers that you can try out in Flight Sim 2020 when you're looking to switch things up a little bit. I've never spent much time doing aerobatics before, so I did a fair bit of research on this one, and I'm going to present to you how to do aerobatic turns, aileron rolls, and loops. There are three airplanes in the standard version of the game that you can use to do aerobatics with. That's the Pitt Special, the Robin Captain, and the Extra 330. The Robin and the Extra are similar in design, and the Pitt looks more like the traditional biplane. It's a legend in the field of aerobatics, and you've likely seen it if you've been to any air show. There are a few things that differentiate an aerobatic plane from a normal plane. The first one is that it's going to be rated for inverted flight. That means it's going to have a fuel and oil system that work at any attitude. The fuel and oil systems are designed in such a way that even if the airplane is inverted, it's going to be able to get whatever it needs out of the tanks. The other differentiating feature of an aerobatic airplane is that it's going to have symmetrical wings that are flat on the top and on the bottom. That allows the plane to fly either right side up or down. One thing you'll also notice about the aerobatic planes in Flight Sim is that they feel excessively twitchy. I'm not 100% sure if the plane is supposed to be this twitchy or they just haven't refined the flight model enough, but it's definitely a little bit of a challenge to fly on takeoffs. Before I get to all the cool aerobatics moves, please make sure to hit like and subscribe if you get any value out of this video. As usual, if you have any comments or you want to critique something that I did, feel free to put it in the comments below. I'm not a pilot, I just pretend to be one in Flight Sim. I'm on the ground just south of Wichita, Kansas today, mostly because this is one place that I knew I could find long straight rows that run north, south, and east, west. They're going to come in really useful as a reference for all the maneuvers that I'm going to do once I'm in the air. I decided to use the Extra because it's the one that I'm most familiar with, and I know there are a few flight experience places that use it as well because, as you can see, it's a two-seater, which makes it perfect for a flight instructor to bring up a student. There are a few things I want to go over in the cockpit that are slightly different from a normal plane before I head up in the air. The first one is the aerobatic sights that are just off the wing to the left. You can tell what your attitude is by referencing the horizon with the lines on the sights. So for example, if this line right here of the sight is parallel to the horizon, that means that you're at a 45 degree angle. Similarly, if the horizon is parallel with this line here, it means you're at a 90 degree angle. It's really useful in the game as well because when you're flying, you can just glance left really quickly and have an idea of what your attitude is. When you're flying the plane, reading the attitude indicator is a little bit hard because those numbers are very small unless you zoom in, and obviously, as you're doing maneuvers, you don't have time to be zooming in and looking at your attitude indicator too closely. The next thing I wanted to look at is the G-meter, which measures how many Gs your airplane is pulling at the moment. You can see I'm on the ground right now, I'm not moving, and the needle is pointing at 1. This makes sense because 1 G is what you would experience normally just walking around in everyday life on the ground. As you start to do maneuvers, this needle is going to go up and down. The harder you pull back on the stick, the harder the acceleration is going to be. In real life, anything past 3 or 4 Gs for most people is going to start to be a little bit difficult on them. The next thing I wanted to point out is that the maneuvering speed is listed right here on the panel. I'm going to do most of the maneuvers at 143 knots, and sometimes I will go a little bit faster. Lastly, I just want to point out that this airplane is a tail dragger. This isn't unique to aerobatic airplanes, obviously, but it does take some getting used to if you haven't flown one before in the game. When you're in the cockpit, you can't see where you're going, so you either have to make something called S-turns to see where you're going, or what you can do, which is what I do, is just use the external view, and it'll just make everything a whole lot easier. Rotation speed in this airplane is around 65 knots, but I've found that once the airplane starts to hit around 30 or 40 knots, that it wants to very heavily veer to the left before it's ready for takeoff. What I do is I apply about 60% power, and I actually do the takeoff from the external camera just because it's a little bit easier to see what I'm doing. I'm gonna have to use a lot more rudder than I normally would to stay on the runway, and I'm also going to have to apply a little bit of right aileron to keep the wing down. I'll demonstrate how to do that right now. So I'm going to apply around 60% power, and I'm going to use the rudder to stay lined up with the center line as much as possible. But as you're going to see, as the plane accelerates, it's going to become harder, and I need to apply some right aileron to keep myself straight. Then once I hit my rotation speed, I just let the airplane take off. That wasn't perfect, but it was one of the better ones that I've done so far, to be honest. At this point, once I'm in the air, if I want to accelerate more or do a faster climb to my cruise altitude, I'll obviously apply a little bit more power. But otherwise, that's the technique I'm using for takeoffs, because the full power at takeoff is just causing me to go off the runway every single time. If you have any ideas on how to make the takeoffs a little bit smoother with this airplane, feel free to put them in the comments below. I'd love to hear any tips and tricks you've found. Before doing any aerobatic maneuvers, you want to make sure to get to anywhere between 3,000 and 5,000 feet above ground level. So the first thing I'm going to show you is the aerobatic turn. You usually do an aerobatic turn to turn one of 90, 180, 270, or 360 degrees. You're often going to combine it with other basic maneuvers that I'm going to show you in a couple seconds to make more complex maneuvers. Really, it's one of the building blocks of aerobatics. So the first thing to be aware of is that you're going to always do aerobatic turns at around 60 degrees of bank. 60 degrees is easy to know because in the attitude indicator in front of you, you've got two markers for 60 degrees, either left and right. Once you've turned your plane to 60 degrees, what you're going to do is start a 2G turn. Now you'll be able to tell how many Gs you're pulling with your G meter right here. It can be useful at times to reset it by clicking on this button right here so that it's a little bit easier to read. A 2G pull on the stick once you're at 60 degrees is going to give you a constant rate of turn, which is one of the criteria that you're judged on when doing those types of turns in competitions. The other two things that you're judged on are the altitude and how accurately you turn out on your turn. To perform the turn, what you're going to do is you're going to do it in two steps. The first step is to use the ailerons to turn to the 60 degrees of bank. Once you're there, what you're going to do is you're going to pause for just a split second. You're going to unload the ailerons, and then you're going to start pulling back on the stick to only operate the elevator. You need the elevator to be neutral when you're rolling to the 60 degrees of bank, because otherwise you're going to have a change in altitude. You always either use the elevator or the ailerons and the rudder, but you never use both of them at the same time. Once you get close to the heading that you're looking to turn out on, you're going to quickly come out of your turn by applying about 50% deflection of the ailerons to get back to your heading as fast as possible. Again, you want to do it one thing at a time, so you unload the elevator and then you use the aileron to get back to straight and level. All of the aerobatic maneuvers you're going to do, you need to be doing them from the cockpit. The external view is cool to be able to see your airplane, but you won't be able to tell what you're doing with any level of accuracy. Alright, so what I am going to do first, I am going to try a very short turn. I'm going to turn to the east. So I'm going to quickly turn in to 60 degrees, I unload the ailerons, and now I'm just using a 2G turn. I'm going to unload the aileron there, and there we go. My airspeed stayed pretty stable at around 140, which was good. My heading is pretty much what I was expecting it to be, 091, which is close enough. I lose a little bit of altitude in the turn because I was applying a little bit of elevator, so I'll try and fix that on my next run. Alright, so let's do that again, but let's do a slightly longer turn this time. I'm going to turn 180 degrees to the left. So again, I'm going to use aileron to turn in very quickly, unload the aileron, and just use 2G to pull myself through all the way till I'm heading west. At which point I'm going to unload the elevator and then use the aileron to come back to straight and level. And there we go. My altitude stayed pretty stable that time. My airspeed dropped a little bit, which isn't fantastic, but it's okay. And my heading is pretty close as well. Next up, I am looking at aileron rolls. I'm showing you the aileron roll today because, again, it's one of those building blocks towards the more complex maneuvers that you can do in aerobatics. Again, you're going to want to have around 5,000 degrees of altitude. just to make sure that you aren't too close to the ground. And this is where the long straight roads are going to come into use. So as you can see, the neat thing about where I'm flying today in Kansas is all the roads run north-south and east-west. So it makes it really easy to have a point of reference when I'm flying to know where I should be pointing and how I should orient myself and how to adjust as I'm doing a maneuver. Performing an aileron roll is pretty easy, but again, getting it just right with the judgment criteria is where it gets a lot harder. The proper technique involves getting up to your maneuvering airspeed and then pulling up on the nose till you have about a 20 degree pitch up attitude. At that point, you neutralize the elevator and you use about 1/3 to half of the deflection of the ailerons to do your roll. You hold the ailerons there until you've completed your roll and you're back at straight and level flight. There are a few criteria you're judged on for aileron rolls. The two that I use to judge myself are a constant rate of turn, as well as rolling out on the same heading that I started on. All right, at this point, I am going to pull back on the stick 20 degrees nose up, and I am going to apply left aileron to turn through the turn, and I'm using the road to make sure I stay lined up. There we go. All right, how did I do there? My airspeed stayed good. My rate of turn was fairly constant. My G's stayed fairly constant throughout the turn. Let's do one more. My initial pitch on the turn was a little bit too high, and I'd like to get it a little bit better. So let's do that again. So I'm going to pull up to 20 degrees, and then I'm going to unload the elevator. I'm going to turn with half of my aileron. And there we go. And again, I used the road to line myself up to make sure I stayed on my heading. I'm a little bit off heading, about 8 or so degrees. I'm pretty sure a judge would judge me very cruelly for that turn. But as a beginner, I think it's all right. All right, on to my last maneuver of the day, and that's going to be loops. Loops are probably the most fun and also the most difficult of the maneuvers that I'm looking at today. You're really going to want to find some long and straight roads for loops. It really makes it a lot easier to tell where you are as you're going through the loop. In acrobatics, the loop is broken up into four different parts, but for simplicity, I break it down into only two. The first half is obviously as you're pulling up through the loop, and the second half as you're coming down. To perform a loop, you'd start off by pointing your nose down around 10 degrees to build up a little bit of energy, and then start a 3 to 4 G pull up to the halfway point of the loop. That's the point where you would be inverted. On entry into the roll, you can use the sights off to the left-hand side of the airplane to quickly get a sense of what your attitude is. I find it's a lot easier to read when you're performing the loop than trying to read the little numbers as they're going by on the attitude indicator in front of you. You want to hold the 3 to 4 G's almost all the way to the point you're inverted and then start letting off a little bit. You need less G's in the second half of the turn because you're going to have the energy of the airplane that's going to build up, and gravity is just naturally going to be pulling you down. In the loop, your primary control surface is the elevator. The aileron and the rudder are really there as secondary to keep you flying straight and level. Once you get to the midway point of the loop, that's where you can make any small adjustments to align yourself with the road below you. You're judged on a few criteria when you're doing a loop. The most important ones that I try and keep an eye on are my airspeed is the same at the start and end of the loop, and my altitude has stayed the same as well, and same thing for my heading has stayed pretty much stable too. The more difficult one to get a sense for, because you're in the game, is the actual constant rate of turn of the loop. It's really hard to tell, and I really wish there was a replay mode that I could very easily go back and see how I did in my loop. Alright, let's give that a go. So I am heading due west. I've got a road right below me, as you can see, and I am going to start by pushing the nose down to build up some excess energy. Hold it right there, and when I get to 163, that's when I'm going to start my 3 to 4 G pull all the way up until I'm inverted at that point right there. Keep pulling through, line myself up with the road, and I'm going to try and do 1 to 2 G on the way down. just like that. There we go. So my airspeed is pretty much where it was when I started the loop. I lost a lot of altitudes. That was not good at all. My heading stayed good, however, so I got 2 out of 3 criteria. Let's give that another go. So I'm going to point the nose down, build up a little bit of energy right there, and now I'm going to start my 3 to 4G pull all the way up and through till I'm inverted. Now I'm going to stay lined up with the road, keep an eye on my altitude, my airspeed. There we go. How was that? Not too bad. I lost around 400 feet this time, which is a lot better than last time. My airspeed is pretty good. It's around 140, which is what it should be at the end of the loop. And my heading is just about right as well. So clearly, I still need to practice loops because I can't seem to get the altitude quite right at the end of the loop. I'm having a bunch of fun practicing these different aerobatics. I hope you give them a go in the game. And if you have any questions or comments or any tips and tricks for me to improve my technique, please feel free to put them in the comments below. And if you got some value out of this video, please make sure to hit like and subscribe. And I'll see you next time.